and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God is love, and we are God's children. There is no room for fear in love. We love because God loved us first. God our Father, we confess to you and to our fellow members in the body of Christ that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry. Forgive us our sins and deliver us from the power of evil for the sake of your Son who died for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. God, who is both power and love, forgive us and free us from our sins. Heal and strengthen us by the Holy Spirit and raise us to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. In the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. O Lord, in your mercy, grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. These are the last words of David, the oracle of David, son of Jesse, the oracle of the man whom God exalted, the anointed of the God of Jacob, the favorite of the strong one of Israel. The Spirit of the Lord speaks through me. His word is upon my tongue. The God of Israel has spoken. The Rock of Israel has said to me, one who rules over people justly, ruling in the fear of God, is like the light of morning, like the sun rising on a cloudless morning, gleaming from the rain on the grassy land. Is not my house like this with God? For he has made with me an everlasting covenant, ordered in all things and secure. Will he not cause to prosper all my help and my desire? But the godless are all like thorns that are thrown away, for they cannot be picked up with the hand. To touch them, one uses an iron bar or the shaft of a spear, and they are entirely consumed in fire on the spot. This is the word of the Lord.
A reading from the Revelation to John. Grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and freed us from our sins by his blood and made us to be a kingdom, priests serving his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Look, He is coming with the clouds. Every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. And on his account, all the tribes of the earth will wail. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. This is the word of the Lord. Amen.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Pilate asked Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask me this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I'm not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you're a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I'm a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Give thanks to the Lord for this, his glorious gospel.
May I speak in the name of God, who creates us, redeems us, and sustains us. Amen. "I could have wept," he said. He was standing knee-deep in a stream, which surged down a narrow ditch beside a ruined path. I'd walked that way 2 months earlier, grateful for the path's firmness and that it allowed me to avoid the mud and the crops growing in the adjacent field. The man was patiently raking and clearing the weeds that choked the stream. He explained how he and his friends had planned the path, got funds from the local council, and set about their task. First, they laid a membrane to keep the weeds at bay, and then tons of agglomerate, pounded and pressed down to create a smooth, hard surface. Then came the autumn storms, and one evening, the stream blocked, and the path was washed clear away. The stone was nowhere to be seen, only the membrane remained, forlorn and pathetic. "I could have wept," he said, "when I first saw it. All those hours we spent building it." Yet here he was, at work again, beginning the repairs. He was part of a local group that maintains paths and rights of way. Come the spring, they'll be back with their machinery, rebuilding. For that's what pathmakers do. They make paths. And when those paths are damaged or obliterated, they make them over again. On this Sunday, the Sunday before Advent, we're invited to reflect on Christ the King. It's understandable that we, who offer our service and obedience to Christ, should seek out images and metaphors that give meaning to that relationship, and these images we draw from our everyday experience. Pilate does just this in our gospel reading. "Are you the King of the Jews?" he asks Jesus. Pilate's a man of political power, of military might, so inevitably he tries to describe Jesus in familiar categories. But note how reluctant Jesus is to play that game. "You say that I am a king. I came into the world to testify to the truth." "What is truth?" asks Pilate. Yet every year on this Sunday, preachers say the same thing. If Jesus was a king, he was such an unusual king that the normal characteristics of kingship don't seem to apply. This means that although our liturgies and hymns use the word all the time, we can quickly lose touch with what it means when applied to Jesus. For Jesus calls himself many things rather than calling himself King. I am, he says, the bread of life, the good shepherd, the true vine. Each title helps us to fill out what his kingship means. This is why I think the story I've just told you of the man in the stream says far more to me about the character of Jesus and the nature of his authority than any number of pictures of Jesus sitting on a throne. I am the way, Jesus says. I am the path. If you want to be my disciple, follow me. This is the one who makes the path straight, the one who prepares the way for us to walk in. He is the one we believe who, when disaster strikes and only a flimsy membrane remains, patiently starts work again and rebuilds the path. He is the one who, on our behalf, perseveres. I gather that the Oxford Dictionary Word of the Year for 2021 is vax, V-A-X, for obvious reasons. The Cambridge Dictionary, on the other hand, offers a very different word for the year. Perseverance. The Mars rover vehicle, of course, exploring that distant planet, is called Perseverance. But the word is true in so many other ways in our own experience over the last months when we really needed to persevere and keep going. Yes, we know what the word means, all right. And we recognise that quality in the man in my story. Indeed, I'm suggesting that the man I met on my walk presents a picture of God and fills out what we mean when we speak of Christ the King. That man who, like God, stood back to survey his work and declared it to be very good, yet who, when all is washed away, has to start again. God too, we believe, patiently perseveres just like that. When storms strike or when we mess up and undo all that seems so good, God too may say, I could have wept. But God doesn't walk away. He puts on his metaphorical wellies, picks up his rake and starts again. All else may have gone, but the apparently flimsy membrane remains. Christ, we believe, is the pathmaker, whose care persists even when we let him down. Christ is the path himself, vulnerable to the hardships of life, yet showing us the way. Christ, yes, Christ is the one beside the path, talking with us as we stumble past. This is the King we worship, the King we imitate, for we're invited to be these things too. Whilst we might wish it were otherwise, our lives do not endure unchanging on. And this is as true of the life of faith as it is of life in general. No sooner do we reach the mountain top than we find ourselves once more plunging into the valley. Just as storms hit or time ravages our buildings and we find ourselves repairing the roof or sorting the gutters yet again, so in our congregational life and in our personal lives of faith, we find ourselves challenged, knocked backwards, stripped down. It's at such times that perseverance is required. These past months of pandemic have been, for many of us, rather like the storm that washed away the path. At times it has felt as if our hard work has been washed clear away. Yet the promise is that the membrane persists, readying the ground for new building. And along the ruined pathway, there will be those to help us build, including Christ himself, who, though he may not always be recognised, is the King who has the power to make our hearts burn with love and hope and joy as we travel in his way.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one substance with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace, we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work, for our families, friends and neighbours, and for all those who are alone. For this community, our country and the world, for all who work for justice, freedom and peace, for the just and proper use of your creation, for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice and oppression, for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble, for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy, for the peace and unity of the Church of God, for all who proclaim the gospel, and all who seek the truth, for our own needs and those of others, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. We will exalt you, O God, our King, and praise your name for ever and ever. We pray for all those who have died in the peace of Christ, and for those whose faith is known to you alone, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them, those who put their trust in you. Gracious God, you have heard the prayers of your faithful people. You know our needs before we ask, and our ignorance in asking. Grant our requests as may be best for us. This we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
We meet in Christ's name. Let us share his peace. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own we give you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Worship and praise belong to you, Father, in every place and at all times. All power is yours. You created the heavens and established the earth. You sustain in being all that is. In Christ, your Son, our life and yours are brought together in a wonderful exchange. He made his home among us that we might forever dwell in you. Through your Holy Spirit, you call us to new birth, in a creation restored by love. As children of your redeeming purpose, we offer you our praise with angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Glory and thanksgiving be to you, most loving Father, for the gift of your Son born in human flesh. He is the Word existing beyond time, both source and final purpose, bringing to wholeness all that is made. Obedient to your will, he died upon the cross. By your power, you raised him from the dead. He broke the bonds of evil and set your people free to be his body in the world. On the night when he was given up to death, knowing that his hour had come, having loved his own, he loved them to the end. At supper with his disciples, he took bread. He gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, it is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Made one with him, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us, and upon this bread and this wine, that overshadowed by the Spirit's life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son, and we may be kindled with the fire of your love, and renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us, who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's body, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love, until at last, in your new creation, we enter into our heritage in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. Amen. The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this sign. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the time of trial, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your peace. This is the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, the gifts of God, the people of God. Thanks be to God. So let us pray together. God of infinite mercy, we thank you for Jesus, our Savior, who feeds his people and gives them eternal life. Though we cannot consume the gifts of bread and wine, we thank you that we do receive Christ's saving presence, the forgiveness of sins, and all other benefits of his passion. Grant that we may continue forever in the risen life of our Savior. Amen. We give thanks to you, Lord, for you are gracious, and your mercy endures forever. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. And we whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you, now and forever. Amen. And now go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.